Evgeni Malkin helped lift the struggling Pittsburgh Penguins squad over the Toronto Maple Leafs tonight. Looking at his pass on this Jason Zucker goal, he wins the foot race and spots number 16 in all alone. He has the quick instincts and the skill to recognize it's more effective to make the spinorama play, and you know, he has the tools to do it. As Mike Johnston on the TSN broadcast pointed out, he was just all over the ice from his goal to his assist, even taking a couple of minor penalties. He was displaying confidence in transition and looked like his 23-year-old self in this game. The Leafs are just struggling at creating 5-on-5 offense at the moment. Tavares and Nylander were buzzing a bit. I mean, they were both in the 70th percentile in expected goals for tonight. And their alignments were switching up a bit. It started off with Robertson, then Kelly Yarncroke got a few shifts there. And they made it work generally. But, you know, the Matthews line wasn't as great as it probably should have been. Zach Aston-Reese finally proves that current Leaf players can score against their former teams as he tied the game early in the first there off another nice play from Dennis Malkin. Now, a main talking point in this game was Brock McGinn's goal that goes short side on Eric Schalker, and that gives the Penguins the 3-2 lead in the third. Here's something to consider. Schalker is a third goaltender, and because of injuries, his workload has changed a lot. Sure, would it be nice for him to have a story like Logan Thompson, who was Vegas' third goalie coming into the year, and now he's putting up elite numbers as their starting goaltender? Yeah, I mean, sure. However, he's providing what you expect, and he's generally given a team a chance to win in most games. But, that, you know, with all due said, that was a tough goal to allow. You know, he allowed more goals than expected of him, according to his negative 1.25 goals saved above expected in this one. I would go with Keith Petruzzelli in tomorrow's game to see what he can do. It would be a great story if in his NHL debut he wins tomorrow night, because that guy's got personality too. I just hope they can do it, man. And you know, we also do have to acknowledge the pregame, I think, in this. It's the Hockey Hall of Fame ceremony. It was very emotional to see Barry Salming out there, man. Daryl Sittler holding his hand, getting emotional. You know, this guy did so much for growing the game in Sweden. Like, you just see guys like Rasmus Sandin look up to him. He spent the summer with him 1 year. Timothy Liljegren, William Nylander. It's so sad to see what's happened with Salming in terms of his battle with ALS. And just to reinforce the Toronto community, you know, coming together, giving him that ovation, man. We're with you, Bori. We are with you. Yeah, it's hard not to shed a tear on that one. So to end this off, you know, the Leafs are mediocre. And, hey, the Penguins can finally score again.